Welcome back to Plecter Labs for a new tutorial video. This time this is about color mixing using a CF board. As explained in the CF user's manual, the color extender board is preferred if you want to achieve high-end color mixing for the simple reason that the CEX board uses current regulators which allow it to deal with greater voltage, hence more runtime and low temperature operation compared to driverless boards, which is also known as direct drive. The manual also explains that you can use CF color mixing without the color extender thanks to the onboard power extenders. While losing the color extender board makes the blade color non-constant during the battery runtime, it's a cost-effective alternative to try color mixing and even makes more sense when used with a single cell, as I explained just after. So, here is our CF that was converted to single cell operation using our previous tutorial. We are going to wire it to get simplified color mixing. Here is what we are going to use. A CF board, further modified to be single cell compliant. A multi-die LED. We're using a triple Cree LED, but it can be an LED engine or a tri-rebel, for instance. Some 2512 SMD resistors. A speaker. A custom CyberShop control box equipped with an activation switch, an auxiliary switch, a recharge port, and a rise port. A tri-lens and the TCSS blade holder so that we can pack everything together. So we have wired our LED dies with individual wires. Now first install the LED on its heatsink base. Don't forget to use some thermal tape to electrically isolate the LED backplate from the hilt. Place the optic on the LED and you're done. Our color setup will be a RGB tri-Cree. And we will first demonstrate a setup using the blue die wired to the CF main channel and current driver. Then the green and the red channels will be wired to the onboard power extender, color channels 2 and 3. Let's first wire the green and red anodes together and solder them to the board main positive. Then solder the green and red cathodes, or negative, to their respective power extender. The green forward voltage is high enough to be direct drive. However, the red will require, in this case, a resistor due to its low forward voltage. If you need to measure forward voltage on a high power LED, you can check my other tutorial. With a single cell power supply voltage of 3.7 volts and a red die forward voltage of 2.5 volts at 800 milliamps, our resistor will be 1.5 ohm and about 1 watt. To stay on the safe side, I'm going to use two 2-watt 2512 SMD resistors in parallel to obtain a 4-watt equivalent. We're using a 4.7 ohm in parallel with a 2.2 ohm, which leads to 1.49 ohm, which is obviously close enough to the expected 1.5 ohm we want for the red die. The two resistors are simply stacked one on the other and soldered together on the power extender. Then we solder the switches, and finally the rise port RX and TX pads to enable real-time control and configuration of the color mixing. So now we can plug the rise cable into the port and remove the kill key to boot up the saver, and finally fire up the board. So the sound volume is on 2 right now instead of 4 because I didn't want to have too much loudness in the background while I was doing that video. So now what we're going to do is to connect to the saver with the RISE application, the RISE program, and we select the COM port that appears here. I have only one. Then connect, and the board answers with echo, which means that it's definitely connected. So now we can read the configuration, and as you can see, it's set on 2 for the sound volume, and I'm set with a momentary switch. Now I can edit the LED configuration and color, and first I'm going to select BGR because this is the way my LED is wired, and now I can select the color. And as you can see, the shade that you have is matching pretty well the color that is just below here. When you look at the blade, I have something which is cyanish, a bit more greenish, and you can change obviously the color to pretty much what you want and go back to your favorite. shade of cyan, for instance, and decide this is the color you want, and finally save on the soundboard. So the saver reboots, and now fire up again, and there you go. You have a single cell compliant CF with simplified color mixing. Now, here is a nice trick for you guys. I demonstrated a BGR setup to detail the calculation and install of the S&D resistor for the onboard power extenders. However, the CF has one current regulator on channel 1, so why not using it to deal with the low VF of the red die and let it deal with the automatic current control? So first, let's remove the resistor and swap the blue and the red channels. Now in RISE, select this time the RGB mixing from FlexiBlend and you're all set. No resistor of any kind nor any magic diode was needed at all for that simple color mixing install using a single cell. I hope you enjoyed that video and it was helpful to you. Thanks for watching and see you soon on the forums.